ranked over him. Because the next player we have ranked over him here at 13th spot, just over Jrue Holiday at 14th, we have Fred VanVleet. So Freddie, undrafted, just got paid, and now we consider him better than Jrue Holiday. What a crazy world we live in.
Yeah. Great.
Love it.
Yeah, he's a guy who I believe I just had him cracking my top 15 or borderline. Personally, he's one of my favorite players. Just based off, I guess, the fact that they do have Kyle Lowry, they do have Norman Powell, and as well on top of that, there is so many good guards. I don't view him as quite top 10 yet. But in terms of the things he could do, he's definitely a really, really good player. He's useful in a lot of different ways. He doesn't crack under the pressure. We saw last year in the playoff run, of course, they didn't win, but he was replacing Lowry in the sense of when it came crunch time, Fred was taking a lot of the big shots in that Boston series. So obviously they're looking to do that transition. And Fred's a great player to replace a guy like Lowry.
He's learned so much from Lowry. He's essentially turning into a very similar player than Lowry is currently. And everyone forgets that it took Kyle Lowry 6-7 years to become an actual consistent starter in this league. Where he was actually being that above average player, even average player. It took him a little while. He went through a couple, back when he was in Houston, he wasn't exactly a star. He was coming off the bench half the games. He was a great backup. He was what we would have considered Fred VanVleet a year or two ago. A great, great backup and good in spot starter minutes. Yeah, Lowry turned himself into a Hall of Famer. And Freddie's learning right now from a Hall of Famer. He's getting mentored every single day. And we're seeing that right now with Malachi Flynn as well, that they're passing that on. They're the same height. They play a very similar game. They're both very great shooters. There's a couple aspects of Fred's game that aren't there yet as compared to Lowry. But I just see Fred as a very, very good point guard in this league. Do I see him as a top five ever? Probably not. But he doesn't need to be. Like, this guy was undrafted. This guy has proven everyone wrong. And he is a major part of the reason why the Raptors have been such a successful team. His role last year was integral. I still remember the day that one day whenever there was all these injuries and VanVleet was in the starting lineup and there were Powell coming back from an injury, Lowry was back from an injury, and the reporter asked Nick Nurse, "Oh, so like now that we're having a full team, like, oh, so who's gonna, like, Fred's gonna go back on the bench?" And Nick Nurse literally says, "Someone is. I don't think Fred is." So, like, that's a 52 to 53 win team. And he's a starter on it, and he's one of the main reasons why they're that good. I can only see him getting better. There's a couple players higher on this list that are really getting a little bit older that he can easily pass in the next couple years. I don't know if he'll crack that top five for a very long time. If he does get there, he might get there. Kyle Lowry was arguably considered a top five point guard the last couple of years, or very, very close to it for that matter. He might be getting a little bit older now, but he was. And Fred, if anything, has a jump start on it.
Yeah, I don't think he'll ever get top five personally. And again,
he's a guy. I don't think so either, but very, very close.
Yeah, I mean, he's a guy who, I mean, he's already ahead of guys, even though in our segment we did say be a lot based off limited playing time, but already guys ahead of guys like Kemba Walker on our list, Jrue Holiday, like you said. More importantly, I'd say maybe a guy like Mike Conley, who they're very similar in the things that they do. And Fred's already, obviously, we see more value because he is on the rise, and Conley's obviously on the decline. Fred's a guy who was actually third in steals among point guards last year, and he was also a guy who was third among three-point percentage for them as well. And really, the only knock is the fact that he did have one of the worst field goal percentage among point guards. I do feel like he takes a lot of unnecessary bad shots. They do drag out the shot clock a lot in their possession sometimes, which leads to that. But at the same time, again, when a guy is so high in the three-point category and his field goal percentage is lower, I guess you could forgive it because, again, you know that he is taking a lot of difficult shots. So that's what it comes down to. A large percentage, I would say maybe 40 to 50% of his shots, probably are three-pointers. So I don't think that's something that's going to be a huge hurdle. I think he'll be at least borderline top 10, and I think that's kind of where we'll see him top out. It's really just a matter of when he gets the full reins of being the starting point guard versus the starting flex shooting guard point guard.
Yeah, right now he leads the team, and in all reality, for a good chunk of the game, even when Lowry's on the court, Fred runs the offense. It gives Al Lowry a lot of minutes off, and that's why I think they're the perfect tandem together. I think I had Fred a little bit higher ranked than you, I think, mainly because, sad to say, I can picture a Kyle Lowry trade this year. I don't want to say that, but I can picture it. It might be very smart and beneficial to the team. I know, don't kill me, guys. I love Lowry, and we'll see him soon on this list. But that's where I'm thinking at, and I can only see him improving on the year last year. And he still already had a very, very efficient, like 17, 6, and 4 year. If you round up, it was 18, 7, and or 18, 7, and 4. So like. He's already a very good player. He plays very hard defensively and doesn't take a second off. That's why I have him so highly ranked. That being said, until he does get to be that starting point guard by himself, we don't know what his actual potential is.
Yeah, he did play 36 minutes per game basically last year too. So a guy
He's
who,
playing.
yeah, and I mean in reality, if you can get 36 minutes a game from a starter and you only need 12 minutes from a bench guy, that's a very good aspect in Minnesota, right? Not to mention they do have at least I would say a one good bench player position, both at point guard and shooting guard off the bench. So those 12 minutes a game are nothing to fill, honestly.
Exactly, and they have a great team there in Toronto. And even though the players, certain players like Lowry, are getting a little bit older, other players like Freddie are coming into their prime.
Definitely. And with that, like you said, maybe we'll see a top 10 spot next year for him.
Yeah, I can see him jumping this next guy. So just right on top.